Yo, you in for a treat right now, man. Whew. Man, there's certain artists, man, that I always say, man, that help me find me. Tech find wow. Tech help our show, the wake-up show that people talk about, you know, all the time. A lot of these teenage kids come up to me, and they talk about, man, I did my due diligence. I researched you before MTV, before Sway in the Morning Shade 4-5. Man, what was that wake-up show thing y'all do, man? That was, I said, man, that was at a time when it was all raw, and we were all young, and we were all hungry. We were all excitable. We were all open vessels. We were all taking information in. We were all learning about ourselves. And we used each other in a sense to kind of come up with our own identities. And there were certain artists that we wanted to play that we didn't feel would get the proper due based on their, if nothing else, their skill level alone. Mm. And then if they had substantive information or content within that skill level, that made them special. That made them leaders, not even by choice, perhaps, but by default. Mm. And by playing their music, we was able to help shape and mold a mentality amongst our listeners that anything you do, any craft, any skill requires a lot of dedication, investment, passion, you know, work, ups, downs, and then that end product is something that is divine that you're giving to the world. This man right here with us today is the quintessential artist when it comes to hip-hop, if you ask me. Never has he ever let you down lyrically. If you trace back his records from Word Life to Jules, Bon Appetit, when he went through his phase, became Star Child, Smoke and Mirrors. I mean, you know, today we talking about same moon, same sun. I'm honored to have him on the show. Give it up for the one, the only OC. OC, wow. Man. Oh, man.
That's big.
You got one of the most memorable lyrics ever said in hip hop. Heather, spit it. You lack
the minimum. We've been doing it all morning. It's embarrassing with OC right here.
No, don't do it, Heather. Don't ruin it. Don't ruin it. No, I'm just kidding.
It's all royalty in here, though.
Yeah.
Queens, kings.
Yeah.
It's crazy, man.
Well, you know.
Deja vu? Yeah.
Yeah. It feels weird. You look good, man.
Thank you. Y'all look good, too.
Yeah, man.
I listen and I watch y'all and I bug out.
Yeah, right?
We 70s babies, though. Yeah, you know,
We're drinking a lot of water.
Yeah.
You know.
And I eat that garlic every morning.
You got that? You ain't on that apple cider vinegar?
Garlic every morning garlic. On an empty stomach.
Mm-hmm. What does that do?
I don't know. It does something. That's something my mama taught me. Like, you know, she chew raw onions, raw garlic. She been doing this over 30 years. Mm-hmm. And my mom's is like almost 80, but she looks young.
Garlic fights a lot of bacteria. You know, it gets rid of a lot of bacteria. So.
Slim, too.
Yeah,
boosts your immune system.
Yeah.
Good for the digestive tract. Oh, when OC came out, you know, the forefather was like the Kool G Raps, the Big Daddy Kanes, and the Rakims, and so on and so forth. And, you know, when we talk about, I'm going to do a parallel between those times, you know, the 94, 95, 96, and what we're saying in 2015, 16, 17. Mm-hmm. And whenever the pendulum starts to swing and it's a changing of the guard, you start hearing a lot of conflict and controversy between the older artists and the newer artists. We've seen that today a lot.
A lot.
What are your thoughts on that?
I mean, music-wise, my thing with the younger guys, the young ladies, let them do what they do. Mm-hmm. Hate it or love it, let them do what they do, because I remember a time when we was their age and nobody...
We could curse. Do what you feel, man.
Nobody could tell us shit. You got to learn as you go along. It's a process. And, you know, I just hate the... I don't even like using the word hate, but I just don't like the titles, the mumble raps and all of it. It's all hip-hop. It might not be your cup of tea. Mm-hmm. But it's all hip hop. Mm-hmm. Don't listen to it if you don't like it. That's it.
That's it. How do you feel? We always talk about the younger generation, but how do you feel about our generation?
Our generation is crazy right now. Like, I mean, I do, just to give y'all a little brief tutorial on touring and stuff like that and what I've been doing. A lot of our generation, 90s heads, my peers, our peers, you know, they a little disgruntled. in a sense. They go out for short paper. Mm. And I don't tour as much, but I pick my battles. Uh-huh. And I know my worth. I know my stock. And it's like, nah, I'm good. Uh-huh. So people like, damn, you must be sitting on M's. And it's like, it ain't about that. But, you know, I'm trying to break that cycle, man. Like, we should all be basically in some type of coalition or some shit. Like, just to let these promoters know, let these people know that, you know, 90s, yeah, that was the 90s, but we still here. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. And on top of that, you have to have good music. You gotta be on top of your game. And you know, it's probably part ego with me and part confidence and just being who I am. But I never looked at my shit as talent. You know what I'm saying? I think you learn talent. My shit was God-given. That's how I feel. That's how I'm always feel. And not many are God-given with it. That's just it. Some people learned it. You know what I mean? I inherited this shit, man. My mom's was a singer. You know, it was peoples in my fam that was, you know, musicians and stuff like that. And, you know, I always read as a kid. So everything led up to this point is destined for me.
What did you read as a kid? What kind of books were you on?
It wasn't even no. My moms used to order Riff.
I remember Riff.
Reading this fundamental.
Yeah.
Dr. Seuss books, Big Brown Bear, Beautiful Bull, Blowing Baboons, Blowing Bubbles, Biking Backwards, Bump, Black Bug, Banana Box. Yo, I got all this in my memory. So I read as a kid. I really, like, she made me read. I used to sit down and cry and be like, well, I gotta read. But she made me read. And she said later on, you see, you can't write without reading. And I was like, damn. And that was it. I ain't even say nothing back.
Wow, OC is here. Digging in the Crates Crew. You know, Show and I talked about working on a documentary years ago. We kind of started it. And then I got to readdress that with Show now. It's a different time. We got to come back to that because the history and the people that have come from this collective. We had Fat Joe on the show last week, and he was giving some stories. You know, I'm up in the Bronx all the time. How did you become a part of DITC?
I don't even know. I always tell people it wasn't no, like, they didn't sit down and say, yo, you know, some mob type shit. It was like, yo, we made a decision.
Yeah.
And you in. I was just, Finesse and Buck. I met Finesse on the Source Tour going out with Organized Confusion, the very first Source Tour.
I remember that.
And I remember Finesse bringing Buck on some of the dates. And that's how me and Buck and Finesse connected. So after the tour, my memory just like lapses. We was recording already. We was doing the demo. And that's, I always been around him. That's how I've been in my mind.
What's a lost art to me, and it's not even in a disgruntled way. I just understand technology now. It's a different time. But what's a lost art is the camaraderie of the studios. We all used to be in studios together.
Exactly.
Whether I was in a B room with Preem or somebody was in an A room or a D room, whatever.
Preem meaning premiere for those who don't know.
Don't do that, Sway. No. What was some of like your best studio sessions? If you could remember, if you could just share one story with us, like some of your flyest like studio sessions, just crazy.
I really don't have any. Just seeing you, seeing Hov, seeing Big, seeing Nas, seeing Smith and Wesson, just all these different people coming through.
Yeah, in one place.
It was normal for us, you know that.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
And to go out to the West and see Ras and the Licks and King T and just bumping into people, and I'm a fan, so it's like, damn, like, and they like, yo, I'm a fan, and I'm like, they don't even understand, man, like, you know, I'm a big DOC fan, even though he's from Texas, I associate with him with Cali, you know, just because of that whole NWA affiliation and what he's done for them, Andre, you know what I'm saying, and it's just normal to me, just to see you coming, yo, what's up, Pounds, you good? And she go in the room and work. It was like that. It was normal.
Was people scared of Heather B back then?
Ooh, I'm just, you know. I hate you.
Heather wasn't no punk, though. She ain't play. You know what I'm saying? But she was cool.
A lot of artists, a lot of kids, we talk about Big L a lot, you mm-hmm. know, and this dude was ahead of his time to me, like yeah. as a lyricist, as yeah. a writer, as an MC. That was something different, man. That was yeah. something channeling, divine intervention. You
that
know?
was Ness and Show.
Talk about that, man. Just for those who don't know who Big L is and why we revere him, rest in peace, so much.
I remember my recollection of L doing the Columbia deal, getting out of that deal, and the transition of lyricism between that time and going into Flamboyant and, you know, the Ebonics. Mm-hmm. Like, I seen the paradigm shift with him.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he was on the Devil's Son shit, but then he got into, he was in his bag. And I was like, wow. You know what I mean? Like, I got to step my game up. You know what I'm saying? I seen him progress in such a short period of time. And, I mean, y'all heard it.
Yeah.
He got on the radio with Hov.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, Stretching Bob, and it was like, whoa.
And he was a little more advanced than Hov back then.
Yeah, yeah. You know. And Jay's my man. Jay yeah, is a yeah. genius in my mind, but L was a genius too.
At that time, yeah, he was, yeah. Oh, man.
L. I seen him, like, we was on tour doing the Jules run, probably 97, early 97. And we was in Europe, and we'd be on Spirit Planes or something like that. Yeah. And he's like, he said certain lines from Ebonics, and I was like, yo, dogs, I'm tired, I don't want to hear that shit. Like, but he was pinning Kid Coatin', and I'm like, all right, so what's after that? He like, so I got dogs. And just walk away, go back to his seat. And it was like, yo, you woke me up for that, man.
Yeah.
Like, he was funny, he was just annoying, you know what I'm saying? And, yo, I got another line, dogs, and he'll spit it, and then he'll walk away. It was like, yo.
Fat Joe told us, L told him, I'm about to kill you on your own shit.
Yeah, he told
was
him.
Was it competitive? Like, yeah. did y'all ever used to get into cypher battles?
Nah, but you know when it was an unsaid competition with all of us. So, you know, when he go in the booth, it was like, you know, I listen to what he do, and I'll probably go out, give me a beer or something, be like, oh, he on some bullshit. All right. You know, same with Ace, same yeah. with Ness.
Same with Ness was another one, Lord Finesse.
They was battle dudes. I'm not a battle rapper.
Yeah.
They was legitimate battle rappers, like, you know what I mean? And that wasn't my bag, but I knew I can, you know, write up some stuff that'll compete with them. But I wasn't no battle rapper. That was their thing. And like I said, L surpassed levels to me early on before he really, when y'all heard Ebonics and Size Him Up, and he was already there. Uh-huh. Y'all just ain't hear it yet. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He was there already. And it was like, y'all, people going to be surprised.
I want to hear a little bit of Big L, and I want to talk about a song on your album that talks about mm-hmm. the last day
mm-hmm.
of his life. Here's Ebonics. Oh, 888-742-3345. Call us. Sway in the Morning. OC is here. Come on. Man, that's about 98. What was that?
94?
98. 98? 98, like that. Yeah. Ebonics. That's when it came out. Yeah. OC is here.
Yeah.
The album is Same Moon, Same Sun.
Mm-hmm.
Couple songs I want to ask you about. I was going to start with Serious because I think Serious. Well, I think the intro to and the first song, Serious, gives a great lucid perspective on things. You're making a complicated existence in this time and era,
mm-hmm.
and you're breaking it down in such layman's terms that either you accept logic or not.
Yeah.
You know, and I want to talk about those things, too. But the song Real Life is like the last song I heard on the album.
Mm-hmm.
And was that therapeutic for you? What made you make this song? And for those who don't know, what is it about?
Real Life was basically something I held on to for, he's been going 18 joints?
Yeah, 18 years.
I held on to it up until I did the record, which was last year. And I just held on to it, man. Like, And I was like, yo, I gotta let that go, man. It was haunting me. You know what I'm saying? And the reason I say that is, you know, for people who didn't hear the song, I was waiting for L and D&D that night. And I think B.I. show was going out of town or something like that. And if I'm not mistaken, he was on the GW Bridge. And I was waiting for L. I'm beeping him. We got beepers packed in.
Yeah.
I'm calling him. I'm leaving voicemails. He's not getting back to me. And reason being was I had another idea to do a record with him. And he wasn't getting back. So I got upset. Not upset, but I was mad. I'm like, that's not him, but, you know. So anyway, I go home. I hop in my whip. And I'm going through the Midtown Tunnel. And I'm still beeping him, calling him. He's not returning no calls. So fast forward, I get home. And my lady was like, yo. I came in the house, and she was teary-eyed. She wasn't boo-hooing, but I'm like, damn, she must have found a number or something. I was like, oh, I done fucked up. What I done did now? So when I got closer to her, that wasn't that vibe. And automatically, I was like, who's dead?
Wow.
And she was like, L. So the first thing that came to mind was Finesse. Both L's.
Yeah.
I was like, Ness? And she was like, nah. L, Big L, show just called. And he's standing right, him and Joe was standing over his body in Harlem. Looking at his boots under the sheet and the tape and all that. And that was that. And I held on to that shit. And I think Show tucked it away. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So he didn't remember calling everybody, but I know he put the call in to everybody.
And that's how you found out Big L had passed away.
Yeah, they was just like, yeah, I'm looking at his boots. You know what I mean? And it was him and Joe.
Wow. I'm going to play this song called Real Life. It's off the album Same Moon, Same Sun by O.C.
Yeah.
Sway in the Morning.
I'm on the promo run in 9-7, Joel's tour. My man Big E and OG and Corleone. I recall it so vivid like it was yesterday. Another story etched on my resume. Out in Germany, the first week I was sick with the flu, yet I made it through. Sipping Remy Ma, scarf around my throat, putting Vicks Vapor Rub up my nose. Popping aspirins, trying to get rest between shows. All this traveling, this cold really taking its toll. Wishing I was back home, getting my relax on. But it's the life of an artist, you know. I wouldn't trade this for nothing in this world. Writing songs took me all around the world. Before the internet and blogs were the end thing, and search engines could pinpoint what was trending. Was no other way to show face, except on TV or videos on BET. Everything back then was hands-on, now I'm on the laptop, renewing my passport, huh? Me and L at the radio stations, on the same tour we met Fat Philly from Croatia. For a last-minute booking out in Zagreb to do a show, that was my last run with Coley, y'all. All of a sudden, everything changed. In the blink of an eye, who's to blame? For a long time, shit was never the same, me and the crew felt the strain. Dark clouds preventing us from shining. Soon after's when I came up with the bright idea to call myself Star Child, to boost my ego in a way. So what now?
Yo, L, you get this message, call me back. I'm not in the lab no more. I'm breaking out, I'm going home, man.
So hit me when you get this message, all right? Peace. I blocked out time, up in D&D. I had an idea for a collab with L. I'm a couple hours in, peace to Dave and Doug. Thanks to Prima, rates are low and L's a no-show. I paged him, but his cell rang out. Now I'm getting pissed, cause I keep getting his voicemail. So now I break out, on my way back through the Midtown Tunnel, back to Crown Heights. Bumping my sister with the CNN's war report. Make it home, found a spot, park my car, go inside. See my shorty with tears in her eyes. Ask her what's wrong, she told me show just called and said L's gone.
OC is here, ladies and gentlemen. Sway in the Morning, Shade 4-5. Same moon, same sun. That's the name of the album. That was thank you for sharing that.
Yeah.
Thank you, man.
Yeah.
Because as therapeutic as it may be, or you had to get it off, giving us this light for a lot of folks who was there. I was on the West Coast. We didn't understand what happened.
Yeah.
We didn't get it.
It's weird, too. He was supposed to go out with Pun maybe that week or the next week, meet Pun in Cali. And Pun got the call and he broke down, had to pull his limo over. Yo, it's so many layers to this story. It's just crazy. So it's just ironic. It's a Pun video on. So for those that don't know, we was all family. I mean, it was DITC, but DITC, Fat Joe had Terror Squad. So it was just crazy, B.
We got Lewis from Tennessee on the line. What up, Lewis?
Hey, Lewis.
Hey, what's up? How y'all doing?
Great.
Good, good, good.
Yeah, I just had a story that relate to, you know, OC. I was, you know, I had a best friend. His name was YB. You know, we had a little rap group forming together called Bad DNA. And it was back in 2012. I was supposed to go out with him that Friday night. It was like a big party that he had hosted. It was like the biggest party in the town, like biggest party, you know. Nobody ever seen a party like this before. And I just overslept that day. I wasn't tired or nothing. It was just something pulling me away from it, you know. And I woke up to a call, you know, that, you know, my homie YB got shot. He got shot, this and that. My homeboy, you know, hysterically crying, and I'm like just confused, like what's going on, this and that.
Right.
It's just overwhelming, you know, and our music, you know, had been on pause for a long time since that happened.
Right.
And, you know, right now I'm trying to get back on track on that. You know, it's been a while. So I'm trying to put the studio together and everything so we can get this going.
Yeah, when you hear when you hear his story and hear a song like that, you know, does that give you some relief or a sense to give you an idea of how you could cope with what happened with your loss?
Yeah, it does. It really does, because, you know, all my friends, they got so much energy in them and they don't want to release it. You know, they don't want to go to the studio, and it's like
we have to let that go sometimes.
All right. You got to get it off your chest, man. All right.
God bless.
Take care, man. Jimmy on the line. Jimmy, what up, baby?
Jimmy, what's poppin'?
Hey, what's up? Listen, I'm down here in Florida, but I'm from 134 Southside, Jamaica, Queens, God bless.
All right.
And I'm going to tell you, when I went away to college, 85, I'm about to hit 50 this year, so I'm going to get this off my chest. OC,
peace.
You know how it was. Queens, you should just listen to Queens. Brooklyn, listen to Brooklyn.
Right.
But that Harlem movement you talking about, they think it started with Puffy. It was before that.
Yeah.
So you was one of my favorite, and don't I want to tell anybody in Southside, one of my favorite mix MCs. Anytime that you was spitting, you and Big L, but I used to shine out personally for me.
Right.
And just hearing, you know, what you went through, I lost a lot of my friends. Every time I would come back to New York.
We all did, man. Like, it's relatable. You know, it's relatable, man. Like, we all have these stories. That's why I speak about it.
Hey, Jimmy, man, won't you buy the album, Same Moon, Same Sun? The thing I like about OC is the same feeling I got when he first came out is the feeling what I get when I listen to his music today.
Wow.
Because it's so current. You know, you got the lyrics to Serious memorized?
I think.
Can you say the first? Can you say them?
The paradigm done shifted. Keep in mind, every single person around the globe is a witness. Reptilians, shapeshifters, motherfuckers think I'm crazy. My listeners are.
Stop right there. What's the paradigm? How you feel like it's shifting?
I mean, shit, we got Trump.
Okay.
That's number one. Now, I'm a little more of a conspiracy theorist, like meathead crazy, you know, deeper. So, you know, the polls shifted.
Yes. Speak on it.
And we seeing the results of that shit right now. Mm-hmm. Like, dudes shooting themselves in the face. Like, it's just things going on. And I'm like, yo, that's not normal. Mm-hmm. It's not normal behavior.
Mm-hmm. Reptilians. Speak on reptilians.
I'm going to tell something crazy, and I'm going to keep it short and sweet. Uh-huh. My cousin is on the train. Gee, cousin Boo. Yeah. He's on the train. He's looking at some lady, an old lady. She's looking at him. Her eyes, he said, and I believe him, blinked vertically. So he's like, damn, I stopped smoking weed, oh, you know, a while ago. So I'm thinking maybe I'm going through withdrawal or something. But he said he caught it. He's coming from work. It's 4:30 in the afternoon. And he's like, yo, I'm bugging the fuck out. But he said at the same time, he shook. So he gets up and walks to the end of the car. The lady gets up, follows him, and sits in front of him again. Because I guess she's like, you caught it. Mm-hmm. You caught it. Mm-hmm. So now I'm going to fuck with you. Mm-hmm. And he was like, yo, I hopped off. You know, he takes the J to M coming from Manhattan. So he said, I hopped off at, he gets off at Myrtle and Broadway. He said he hopped off at Flushing. And was just shook. And he was like, damn, I was looking. I'm calling dudes to get a bag of smoke now. Now I need some smoke. Because he was like, yo, I was tripping. And I don't know where that came from. And I was just like, yo, B, it is what it is.
Reptilians are believed to be an alien race?
Yeah, alien to us.
To us, yeah. Exactly.
Who's to say they're aliens, though? Like, it's things here that we don't want to accept. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of people just, I tell people this all the time, and I might get a shitload of backlash for this. People like, yo, talk religion, I believe in God, blah, blah, blah. So I told somebody one day, you never seen God, right? He spoke to you? Yeah, he spoke to me. You sure? Yeah. All right, so what's the difference in believing in werewolves and vampires? And he was like, that shit don't exist. So I said, how you know God exists? I'm not saying he don't or she don't, mm-hmm. but you know, I equate that to vampires and werewolves. Like, you gotta believe in everything if you're gonna believe in one thing. You know what I'm saying? If you're gonna believe in certain things, like, it's things that we don't know about. It's dimensions. Music is frequencies. Mm-hmm. You know, people can get programmed. It's all kind of things happening, man, and you know, people just don't understand. And I don't preach. You know what I'm saying? Unless somebody tries to preach to me and tell me what they think or they feel is facts. And that's when I get in their ass.
You could pick up from that bar you left off on?
Keep in mind, you know, reptilian shapeshifters, motherfuckers think I'm crazy. My listeners are. The ones who's open-minded to hear me out without leaving a room for doubt. Viacom got your brain on mute. Drug barons got you stuck off lean and you pair it with some weed. Topped off with amphetamines, readily available like sweets from a corner store. Dear Lord, I don't get it. Conditioning mind, body, and spirit by your own hand. Come on, man. Hidden rituals are now visual, prescribed by an order, and then gets recorded. Human acts of violence, such and such, murders at an all-time high. I mean, it's I'm talking what's going on. I'm not
making it up.
Yeah, like... I'm telling people, like, yo, I'm in a zone, like, and y'all might not be in that zone, but I'm going to get you in that zone without, really being preachy to you. So if I got to turn on a frequency with a certain kind of music and pair it with my lyrics, then I'm going to make you listen.
OC, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
You know, it seemed like we've been talking damn near 40 minutes.
Salute.
Wow. Man, you might have to come back up, bruh.
I'm with it.
Because Lord Sir is up next. He's one of us.
Okay.
You know,
But this is an album that I've thoroughly enjoyed listening to. You know, just as a fan of this, immersed in the culture, and then as a learner, I love information. I love confirmation. Mm-hmm. A lot of things you say, I think and say too. Mostly in private conversations.
In private conversations, because people not ready for.
Yeah, you can't. Just
not ready to receive it.
Exactly.
Yes, yes. But when you put it in music form, it kind of lightens the blow.
Yeah, right. you can sprinkle it.
Yeah.
A little bit, you know, without over seasoning it. And I mean, before we get up out of here, me and Show recorded maybe 70, 80 records. It's two more parts to this. So.
Okay. Okay.
You know, we just couldn't just give it all, you know what I'm saying? Because people would have been like, hold up, wait, like, it's too much. And I can't wait for people to really understand what I'm doing with this right here, because this is phase one, B.
We're going to help them understand.
OC, baby.
Hey, man, wait, before you go, man, I want to thank our guest today that came by.
Chrissy Metz.
All right. And don't forget, go to Sway's Universe.
Yeah, we have so many different videos that are up. You can see Kay Upton. You can see Keisha Cole. Mm-hmm. Enjoy the long weekend, folks. And you can find me on Twitter, Instagram, at It's Tracy G, ITSTRACYG.
Okay.
Go to Amazon.com, too. Check out Sway and King Tech. They breaking down all this. It's like an extended version of the conversation we having right now. Go check it out. And you can hit me up all weekend at the Happy Hour WHB. It's going to be food and drink recipes on the Grizzam.
I'm on Instagram. I am OQ on Instagram.
Yeah, oh, take that shirt off. Long weekend, baby.
Yeah, I'm on Instagram, too. It's really DB. I'll take my fucking shirt off.
Okay, all right. OC, how can they reach you directly? They want to. Hey, man, hit up OC direct.
At OCDITC, that's my Instagram, and the real O Sizzle is my Twitter, and I'm just new to all this cyber shit.
Yeah, but work with. Don't get too caught up on it.
Nah, I'm good. I'm good. I opened up.
Can I ask you for a favor? It's okay if you curve me on this.
What's up?
Hey, dude, I gotta tell you, the Wake Up Show, one of all time favorite songs, is Time's Up.
Woo!
Wow. Let me know see if I remember that for real.
Take a second. If it's okay, man. If it's not, we could come back to do. I want.
Nah,
to
let's do it.
Okay. Oh my gosh.
Hey man, that's the end of the show, man. We're gonna end it with bars. Lord Sirius up next. Sway in the morning. OC, Shameful Five.
So I need to do this, huh?
Yeah. This is what a real MC is. This is a true hyena. Sway in the morning. Shameful Five.
Yeah. Time's up. You lack the minerals, vitamins, irons, niacin. Fuck who did I offend? Rappers, sit back. I'm about to begin about bow talking squawk. Never even walk the walk. More or less destined to get tested. Never been arrested. Album it manifested. Things that I saw, did I heard about or told firsthand. Never word of mouth. What's in the future for the fusion and the change? Rappers are in danger. Who will use wits to be a remainder? When the missile is aimed to blow you out of the frame. Some will keep their limbs and some will remain the same dudes with the gab about killer instinct. Return bitch, knowing damn we lacking this. The connoisseur, cracking your head with a 4x4. Realize y'all, always the coming like Noah, always simmer you down. Perpetrating facade, what you consider an image. To me, it's just scrimmage. I feel I'm stoned. Not cause a bopper with my cap cock. The more emotion I put into it, the harder I rock. Those who pose lyrical really ain't true. I feel. Put them up, yeah. Put them up, yeah.
Put them up, yeah.
Put them up, yeah. Put them up, yeah. Sway in the morning, yeah. Hella B, yeah. NY, yeah. Cali, what up, yeah. Cali, what up, yeah. Everybody in the place. Cali, what up, yeah. Brooklyn, QU, Check it out. Speaking in tongue. How about what you did, but you never done it? They admit it, you bit it. Cause the next man came platinum behind it. I find it ironic. So I researched and analyzed. Most right about stuff they fantasize. I'm fed up with the ball on this focus of weed and clip. And glass getting caught, wax not being flipped. It's the same old, stranded from your anal. Context is not complex to vex. Why you pushing it? Why you lying for? I know where you live, I know your folks. You was a sucker as a kid. Your persona's drama that you acquired in high school and acting class. Your whole aura, let me break it down.
What's the face to me? You shot the kid like we can apart. That's a lie. You was in church with your mom. See, I know, yo, slow your roll. Get with good to go. Guys be lacking in this thing called rap just for dough. Of course I gotta pay rent. Money connects, but yo, I'd rather be broke and have a whole lot of respect. It's the principle of it. I get a rush when I bust some dope raps a row. Maybe somebody you quote. That's what I consider real in this field of music. Instead of putting brain cells to work, they abuse it. Non-conceptual, non-exceptional. Everybody's either crime related. I'm here to make a difference. Besides all the ripping, traps I'm not sticking. Rappers stop flipping. For those who pose lyrical, but really ain't you a bill. Same moon, same sun, y'all.
You black rappers,
same moon.
Whack rappers,
same sun, y'all.
I hate you.
Wait.
Same moon, same sun. Get it, OC, out now. Ladies and gentlemen, we have nothing left to say.
It's Sway in the Morning, only on Shea 45.